Okay, here we go. All apologies, B Club. I'm not a techie, so I'm sorry this is late, but thanks for tuning in. And my techie is right there on the screen. That's Mason, and he's helped me through this. Brian Schonkweiler was right. Just find a kid to do it. They'll know what's going on. So, here we go. This is the Saga of the Almonds continuing, the California story. Here are the bees coming back home. No, they were leaving in that picture. And that was back in December. Then in January, I went out there to the almonds. There's an almond grove. It was in this little area called, it was around Turlock, south of Modesto. And cool little place. It's surrounded by almonds. It helps to know some Espanol, un poquito, because that's like the language out there. I was in a holding yard with several other beekeepers. There's my hives, and this is January 20th. They got them out there, and so they'd been sitting for a month. And when I got out, they looked pretty good. I was happy, you know, to see bees. There's my broker, Denise Qualls, with her Saturday Night Pinks on there. And so, yeah, I didn't know what to expect, whether they need fed or protein or what. You can see from that frame right there, they had plenty of honey. They were still heavy, so I didn't need to buy syrup. But they didn't have any brood on them. There's me modeling my very pretty bee suit. So I needed to feed them protein. And those are global patties with actual pollen in them. And so I just started feeding. And this was basically I was out there 2.5 days and got through 400 some hives, 408 hives. All in all, they looked great, just no brood. They were just starting to lay eggs. So it took a while to get through them, but got them fed in 3 days. And there are the almond trees. That's not my shot. That was happened about a month after I left. So while we were waiting, we made a lot of nuke boxes, hoping for the best. This is end of January into February. The bees are, you know, doing their job. I was getting good reports out there, and we were chopping wood. The bees here at home were needing protein, and so, you know, on the warm days I gave them some protein, but they were having a rush of protein out in California. The 400 that were out there, that's a pile of protein I put on these bees. And basically into March, I lost like 20% of the bees here. It was a rough time for these girls, but wondering how they did. They had only, I lost like 2%, maybe 12 hives out there. And then they came home. This is March 25th. Big Alberto was the driver and pulled in and helped him fold up the tarp. And just real curious what I'd find here, and got them unloaded. Took about 3 hours to load the truck in December, about hour and a half to unload. Pretty quickly, I could see they were strong hives. You can see under that one on the top, those are bees hanging down. And so I was in a good mood. I could see they weren't dead and they looked good. This shot, if it was lower, okay, there's some bees coming out. A lot of entrances were getting clogged with bees, and pretty quickly the heat was coming up, and we were having to smoke them in just to keep them there. And there he goes by Alberto. Thanks for the load. Thanks for getting them out of COVID out in California. And on down the road he goes, and then we took another couple hours to lay them out there in the bee yard, and got them all laid out and started looking through them. And this turned into a very happy day. You can see they were strong, they were healthy. They even filled some feeders with almond honey. And so I was just, you know, kind of giddy, popping lids and looking and just thinking, wow, how am I ever going to keep up with this? And they were brooded. Whereas back in January, end of January, very little brood, a few eggs, they were solid, solid brood. And you can see there a nice shot of some of the honey that they made. Every year isn't this good in the almonds. I heard this was fantastic weather. But pretty quickly, I decided, well, at least for the hives going in apples, we're going to put a top box on there and of just foundation, really, and let them build up into that. And we'll split those like that. So you can see they were strong, and they did. They built a brood nest up in there. And while the apple hives are doing that, that was like maybe 100 hives. The rest of them went out to the outyards. And so that was a before and after shot there of me. I just spent about a week and a half taking bees out and around to the outyards. And then I had to go get the packages. That was a kind of a wrench in the works there. I had to stop working and get packages. And so we hived them up. I don't know why I even showed this, just to show that, man, it's so nice to have bees that are strong versus these package bees. This shot right here is a split that came out of the apple hives, and we started making nukes after thing. This is mid-April, and I could see the queen cells were starting right there. They were already thinking swarm, and so we really rushed it to get around. Leif and I were busy nuking everything up, and it was a race. I mean, good and bad weather. You can see that brood. They were strong. They were thinking swarm, and this is all just the ripple effect from having pollen in February from the almonds, and so we just nuked and nuked. And just solid. The hives look like that, most of them. 90% needed split, and really they could be split again. I'm having a lot of swarms right now. Every yard, we hope for good weather that day and layout. We could do about 3 yards a day if we were hustling. The kids helped some. There we are. Maisie was helping while the others went fishing that day, and we got them all laid out and started selling them. Most are gone now. We split off about 300 some nukes, and there goes a big load of them. Went up to Laura Urban, wholesale these things. And after we got through the nuke boxes, 300 some, we just started making regular hive body nukes, and that's what those are, singles. And April really kind of sucked with the weather, but a few good days, you could see the bees were really pulling in the pollen. They were on the dandelions. And then this last week and a half, we have just dealt with so many swarms. They're coming. I mean, we tried. We split and still couldn't keep up with them. And that's just from strong bees, starting with almonds. So I've got some ideas for next year of how to keep up with this. Somewhere in there, the bees went to the apples. Those had been split twice at that point, and then they were sat in the apples for 10 days. Oh, I thought that was a cool shot. I put that on the beekeeper Facebook page. There they are at night under the full moon. And came home from the apples, and I'm just now getting around to checking these hives, and there's one that has been split twice. This hive has been split twice, and they look like that. So I'm supering them up, and we are making honey. The hives that didn't go into the apples, most of them have a decent sized box of dandelion or dead nettle or something on them. And that's what we did all the last 2 days, just super up hives. Some of them are three high now. A lot of them are three high. This was a good yard. You can tell the hives that have swarmed
and the hives that we caught in time, they're going to make 3 boxes of honey if we get this honeysuckle coming in a few weeks. So my timer says that is the end of the presentation, and we're going to stop it here shortly. Thanks for listening, and I hope this did okay with the tech people. Thank you.